14, 15, 16, prime, 18, prime, 20, 21, 22.
Isosceles, scalene, equilateral, rhombus, trapezoid, tetrahedron, dodecahedron.
Miss Coleman, why don't you solve the equation on the board?
We took up a collection amongst the teachers and such.
If the product of two terms is zero, then common sense says at least one of the two terms has to be zero to start with. So if you move all the terms over to one side, you can put the quadratics into a form that can be factored, allowing that side of the equation to equal zero. Once you've done that, it's pretty straightforward from there.
In all my years of teaching, I have never seen a mind like the one your daughter has.
If we alter the exterior from smooth to corrugated, the capsule might have more stability, but the friction it is under during re-entry, most shield erosion occurs on the posterior side abutting the retroboosters. Conclusion?
The area closest to the boosters is closest to the heat. Coupled with rising temperature on re-entry, the contact softens. We could consider another fastener other than the bolts.
Yes. Yes. Paul, why are we still using shingles off the heat shield?
We're working with a prototype of the capsule, Al. It's literally one-third the size.
I get that. So what do we do with our million-dollar fan, Carl? Turn it down?
No, Al, I don't think.
It was a joke. Paul, if the heat shield comes off, what do you think happens to our astronaut?
I know.
So we're gonna come up with a solve, right?
Yes, sir. We're working on it.
Ruth, what's the status on that computer?
She's right behind you, Mr. Harrison.
Does she handle analytic geometry?
Absolutely. And she speaks.
Yes, sir, I do.
Which one?
Both. Geometry and speaking.
Ruth, get me the... You think you can find me the Frenet frame for this data? Using the Gram-Schmidt...
Orthogonalization algorithm? Yes, sir. I prefer it over Euclidean coordinates.
Okay, good. Good, then I'm gonna need it by the end of the day.
Yes. On any given day, I analyze the manometer levels for air displacement, friction, and velocity, and compute over 10,000 calculations by cosine, square root, and lately, analytic geometry by hand. There are 20 bright, highly capable Negro women in the West Computing Group, and we're proud to be doing our part for the country. So yes, they let women do some things at NASA, Mr. Johnson. And it's not because we wear skirts. It's because we wear glasses. Have a good day.
Is that correct?
Yeah.
Whose work is that? I said, whose work is that?
Catherine Goble, sir.
How did you know the Redstone couldn't support orbital flight? That's classified information.
It's top secret.
Well, it's no secret why the Redstone tests keep failing. It's fine for suborbital flight, but it can't handle the weight of the capsule and push it into space. The numbers don't lie.
And you figured all that out with this. Half the data is redacted.
Well, what's there tells a story if you read between the lines. The distance from launch to orbit, we know. Redstone mass, we know. Mercury capsule weight, we know. And the speeds are there, in the data.
You did the math.
Yes, sir. I look beyond.
End of the day.
Okay, we're looking good.
Okay.
Sir, it might be the selector latch.
I'm taking a walk.
The IBM 7090 data processing system. It has the capability of solving over 24,000 multiplications per second.
Holy Moses, that's lightning fast.
They'll never get that to work.
Oh, it'll run eventually. And when it does, we have to know how to program it. Unless you'd rather be out of a job.
No.
The computer uses it as its high-speed storage unit and information holding device. You have a brain.
That I can work with.
Well, that's in the wrong spot. Atta girl.
The Redstone rocket went straight up. But the capsule didn't have enough speed to go into orbit, so it came back down. Essentially a triangle. Earth. Suborbit. Earth. That math was known. That took Shepard. Took Grissom. That cannot take Glenn. Now, the Atlas rocket, that can push us into orbit. Goes up, delivers the capsule into an elliptical orbit. Earth's gravity keeps pulling at it, but is going so fast, it keeps missing the Earth. That's how it stays in orbit. Now, getting it back down, that's the math we don't know. Yes, Catherine.
So the capsule will spin around the Earth forever because there's nothing to slow it down?
That's right. Slowing it down at precisely the right moment, at precisely the right amount, that's the task. Yes, Catherine.
So it needs to move from an elliptical orbit to a parabolic orbit.
Yes. That's the go, no-go. Now, at this point, it's a pinhead. We bring him in too soon,
he burns up on reentry.
That's right. We bring him in too late, he's pushed out of Earth's gravity.
And any changes to mass, weight, speed, time, distance, friction, or a puff of wind would alter the go-no-go. And we start our calculations over.
Yes. So we need to be able to choose this reentry point. This go, no-go, this has to be exact. Sam, these are the latest Redstone numbers in current capsule data. Obviously, we know the launch spot.
Thanks, Sam.
Pentagon briefing should illuminate where the Navy needs the recovery zone. Then we work backwards from there. And the rest is on us, so let's get to work.
We're orbiting the Earth at what speed now?
17,544 miles per hour at the time the rocket delivers the capsule into low space orbit.
Well, that's one hell of a speeding ticket.
Okay, so we have the vehicle's speed, the launch window, and for argument's sake, the landing zone is the Bahamas. Should be enough to figure the go, no go?
Yeah, in theory, sir.
We need to be past theory at this point.
We'll be able to calculate a go, no go with that information.
When exactly is that going to happen?
Catherine? Have a go at it?
The goal point for re-entry is 2,990 miles from where we want Colonel Glenn to land. If we assume that's the Bahamas, at 17,544 miles per hour, upon re-entry, 370 feet at a descent angle of 46.56 degrees, distance velocity squared, sine, gravity squared, sine, 32 feet, and the distance would be 20,530,372 feet, or 2,990 miles, or 46.33 degrees. Okay, so that puts your landing zone at 5.0667 degrees north, 77.3333 degrees west, which is here. Right here. Give or take 20 square miles.
I like your numbers.
Thank you.
That, of course, is assuming the capsule hits the reentry point exactly. How do we ensure that?
Well, that's the math we don't have yet, gentlemen.
We're working on it.
You know what your job is, Paul? Find the genius among those geniuses. Pull us all up. We all get to the peak together, or we don't get there at all.
Yes. Well, good night, sir.
Is when the capsule moves from an elliptical orbit to a parabolic orbit. There's no mathematical formula for that. As we can calculate launch and landing, but without this conversion, the capsule stays in orbit. We can't bring it back home.
Maybe we've been thinking about this all wrong.
How's that?
Maybe it's not new math at all.
It could be old math. Something that looks at the problem numerically and not theoretically. Math is always dependable.
For you, it is.
Euler's method.
Euler's method?
Yes.
That's ancient.
But it works. It works numerically.
That's it.
Manned attempts, which were canceled for various mechanical or system. The rocket itself is A-OK, and the weather here at Cape Canaveral is
anything from Langley?
Flight conditions.
Not yet.
We are being told that mission control at NASA is conducting a final check of the launch and recovery coordinates, including the go-no-go calculations, so crucial to a safe and successful launch and recovery.
After years of waiting and months of delay, Colonel Glenn,
on NASA's behalf, but let us say without reservation that the safety of Colonel John Glenn is paramount to the mission and to the nation itself.
That's it.
We can confirm the go-no-go point for re-entry is 16.11984 degrees latitude. Minus 165.2356 degrees longitude. The launch window is a go. The landing coordinates match.
Well, that is very good news, Al. It's a little hard to trust something you can't look in the eyes.
That's right, Colonel. Catherine did manage to calculate a few decimal points further than that hunk of metal.
Tell them not to jettison the retro package.
Tell them not to jettison the retro package.
NASA is confirming there is some sort of malfunction with the capsule's heat shield, and it may not stay in place.
The heat shield's loose. The retro package straps might hold it in place.
Will that work?
It will work. It will hold it until he reaches the go-no-go point. It will work.
Al, he has to override the 05G.
Do it.
Friendship 7, we're recommending that the retro package not, I repeat, not be jettisoned.
This means that you will have to override the 05G switch.
Roger. Is there a reason for this? Over.
Stand by, 7. Not at this time, 7.
Roger that command. I will make a manual 05G entry.
And bring the scope in. Over.